Hello fellow RPG makers and welcome to another video. In this video I will talk about custom data, how to load custom data, how to save custom data, and I will also talk about custom data files, how to load them. However, before we start, I want to apologize if you hear some background noise from the outside, but there is currently a reconstruction of the roads and sometimes it gets really noisy, so I apologize for that in advance. Anyway, let's jump into it now. And let's take a look first at loading the custom data files. If we take a look inside Data Manager, we can scroll a little bit down to see that Data Manager.underscore_data_files contains exactly the data classes that we can see here. If we launch the game, open the console, and say data, we can see all sorts of data things. All of them get loaded. Loaded here inside load database, and they are loaded from inside the database files array. So if we want to load some custom data files, let's create some new file, custom.json, and let's have an array here that contains 5 members, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just for simplicity, if I save it and go back to RPG managers, since this is an array, I don't even need to copy it. I can just copy one of the entries and paste it here and do what I would do normally with an array and just small types of pushing. Data manager, oops. Dot underscore database files dot push and data custom and custom.json. Now if I save it and launch the game, oops, I need to close the game, I forgot. So I launch the game, open the console, and data custom, hit enter. I can see that the array is already here. It contains 5 members, just as it should. So that would be the custom data files. If you want to see in detail what happens, you can see the load data file function. You can see that it takes the name and puts it as a window property. And the response text of the file gets parsed via json.parse, which is a native JavaScript function and handling of JSON files. Now loading custom data in terms of variables would be more difficult a little bit because if I just was to define a custom variable like var actor energy, let's say, if I want to create a custom battle system, I need some energy equals 500. Of course, this is not enough because if I now change the custom energy, actual energy, to 450 and try to save it, if I now close the game and relaunch it, I saved it as 450 or at 450, but if I now see it, it is still 500. That's simply because if we take a look at how that RPG maker handles saving, inside RPG managers we can see, not here but a little bit down, or you know what. Let's just search for load save file. Load save file info here we have. So this is not right. Oh, load game. Data manager.load game. It then calls load game without rescue. So if we search for load game without rescue, we have it here. We can see the create game objects function that we have seen up here, not up here, not down here. Up here we have the create game objects, or you know what, create game objects. That it creates the game objects, and then we have seen the extract save contents, and we can also see that it is not handled through json.parse but jsonx.parse. Now jsonx.parse is defined inside RPG core, and it is a static class that handles JSON with object information. That is an important thing to note, because JSON parse, if you have an object like inside a data whatever, for example here we have an array, but here we have an object, if we had this object and we had a constructor here, the constructor would simply get ignored, so it would get loaded as a generic object and not as a class. Where I wanted to go, oh my, RPG managers. Anyway, let's go back here. As you can see here, we have three functions: make save file info, make save contents, and extract save contents. All three of them are kind of important, because the make save contents and extract save contents, as you can see, handles the game data, where make save contents is for saving and extract is for loading. However, the make save file info is important here. Oops, let me move it. And as you can see, here we have info.title, which is the game title that we have here, info.characters, which are these four sprites. There are also faces saved, but they are not used in the default menu. Here we have the info.playtime and timestamp, just to decide when it was saved. If you want to upgrade it, we of course can. For example, if I have a difficulty set, I can go info.difficulty equals game system.difficulty if I have it defined, but never mind that for now. I could then print the difficulty somewhere in the menu, but never mind that for now. We will take a look at the save contents. Now of course, since only the game objects are influenced, there are two things we can do with it. We can either just define the variable in our game object. So if I go new game, open the console, I'll move it to the left because it is straining my eyes, and go game system dot actor energy equals 500. Now if I print it, it is 500, and if I save it and close the game, now if I go new game, open the console, I can see that game system dot actor energy is undefined. However, if I load our game, game system dot actor energy, it is 500, because in this game this data got saved. So that is one way to save custom data. And the other way, of course, is to redefine these objects or these functions. You can either alias it, or you can just copy paste it if you want. And now let's say I want a custom object, so contents.custom equals game custom, and content game custom equals contents.custom. So now if I save it, I need to define a custom class. So game custom function game custom this dot initialize dot apply this argument game custom dot prototype dot initialize equals function this.x equals 5. Now, if you notice, I am not typing in the prototype.constructor line because it is not really needed. This is automatically a constructor for the game custom class. However, I still type it inside the RPG windows and other things because it is kind of a convention. If I take a look at the custom classes, I can see that it is done like that. Oops. Window selectable. I can see it is done like that, so for consistency reasons I do it like this, even though this line is completely unnecessary. Anyway, let's go back to our business. First, let's make a save here. And since we defined our custom class, let's now launch the game. New game. Now, before I do anything, I need to know that even though I have just defined a custom class, due to how JavaScript handles properties, it will not crash if I try to load a non-existent class data. If I go game custom, it is simply undefined. But if I, oops, I did not mean to close the game. If I go new game, game custom equals new game custom, something happened. So let's see the error. Game custom dot prototype. Oh, initialize, I have a typo here. So let's close the game and relaunch it. And new the game. Now if I initialize the game custom object, I can see it is a game custom class. And if I save it now, relaunch it, continue and open it, I can see game custom, it opens, and as you can see, I have my object fully loaded with all necessary properties. So that will be custom data, and that will be it for this video. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments, and I'll see you at the next video. Bye bye.